Welcome back to my channel. I hope you're all doing really well. So today, I thought I would take the 16 personalities quiz. I watched JBA Smars, the queen, obviously, her video of this that I think was quite old, but I don't really know for sure. But in any event, I thought it was a fun little idea, so I thought I would take it. So I'll link it below. I would love to know what your personality type is as well. I remember taking this a few times. I remember last year was the first time I kind of took it. Really paid attention to the results. I think I was just a lot older this time around, so I knew more about myself and the kind of person that I am. And I remember being so amazed by the results and being like, that is me. And it felt really cool to, well, like it says on the screen, like to be understood. It was like, wow. And then I remember yourself to other people. I guess I would agree slightly, like, I'm shy in the sense that I feel like I'm annoying, so I don't want to bother people. So, I guess so, but I'm not really a shy person at the same time. You often get so lost in your thoughts that you ignore for your surroundings. Yeah, I would definitely agree with that. It's like my entire very oblivious because I'm very in my head. You try to respond to your emails as soon as possible and cannot stand a messy inbox. Me to a T, oh my word. You find it easy to stay relaxed even when there is some pressure. Disagree. Very much disagree. I can't do anything under pressure or if like people are watching me. I'm not a quick thinker. I'm not stupid, but I like to be in my own quiet space. You do not usually initiate conversations. I'm gonna agree, but again, I'm gonna agree slightly because it's only the case if I'm in a large group or with someone new, because again, I feel annoying. But if it's like me and two other friends, like, then I'll initiate a conversation if nothing is happening. Like, I'm not incapable of thinking of random stuff to say. I'm very chatty. You rarely do something just out of sheer curiosity. I can't even think of an example, so I guess I agree. I don't know. This is hard. I wonder if I'm gonna get the same answer. This is kinda cool. You feel superior to other people. Disagree. 100%. Being organized is more important to you than being adaptable. Okay. I think I agree, but not 100% again, because I'm very, very organized. Neat freak type of thing, but at the same time, sort of in between there. You are highly motivated and energetic. Yes, very hard worker. Workaholic, really. Winning a debate matters less to you than making sure no one gets upset. Winning. Oh, wait, okay, I'm done. Sometimes I have to read this a few times because I get confused. So winning a debate matters less to me. Yes. Yeah, okay, yeah. 100%. People pleasing, like I said. You often feel as if you have to justify yourself to other people. Yeah. Your home and work environments are quite tidy. You do not mind being at the center of attention. Disagree, but how much do I disagree? I think I'll just do a little disagree. Wait, you do not mind. Yes, so I mind, okay. I get very confused about the sentence structure. You consider yourself more practical and creative. I would consider myself practical, but I also think I'm quite creative. I think I'm gonna do the middle there because I'm not sure. People can really upset you discreet. Well, upset me in the sense that I'm very easily made sad. It's very sensitive, but I'm rarely made angry. So I don't know what the upset means there. Your travel plans are usually well thought out. I'll have to show you guys, especially if you watch my other channel. I'm going away in like a month and a bit to Europe. And same thing with all my previous travel plans I make. I go in Excel or numbers on the computer. On my computer, no. I have like this spreadsheet with the time and where we're gonna be and extra info, like where to order your Ubers or for photography things, like what time of day. Like it's very meticulous, very planned out. I'm happy to not stick 100% to it. I more so like to have it as an idea. Like if I can't go on vacation and not know what we're doing. It's just, yeah, unless we're going to like an all-inclusive Cuba, like I'm just like gonna chill at the pool. But anything else that involves needing to do stuff, it's often difficult for you to relate to other people's feelings. That's great. I feel like I can very, very easily put myself in other people's shoes, which is why, again, I'm very, very sensitive. Your mood can change very quickly. I can't agree. I hate this about me. Like, I'm not bipolar because my people in my family are bipolar, so, like, I know what that is actually like. But I definitely have mood swings. I can be my kind of two moods. Like chill, I guess, are very, very excited, like jumping out of my seat excited, or like really sad, and I can change very quickly. I even, side note, but if you've been watching me for a while, you know that I was on, or I guess I still am on, anxiety medication, and I found that kind of unintentionally helped to balance out my emotions, and less to feel very, very sad, because my medication is also for depression, and so even though that wasn't my like intentions for taking it, I think I noticed that kind of secondhand and found that my mood was a lot more balanced. And I've been recently trying to go off it, so I'm about half my dose right now, and I've 1,000,000% noticed a difference, and I didn't think that I was going to at all. I thought like, okay, I'm good, I don't. Thought I'd show you River. Mm-hmm. You mommy's good girl. Oh, side note as well, but if you've been watching for a while, you'll have seen me pick up the Riviera child many times. And normally she freaks out in my house because she hates being picked up. But she has been getting so much better lately. Like, she still doesn't like to be picked up, but she freaks out a lot less. She was basically adopted, found, like, kind of lost in some factory field, so we don't know what happened to her, so I get why she's afraid of stuff all the time, but she's kind of getting used to life here and realizing she's safe, which just makes my heart very happy. She's still like a scaredy cat, mind you, but less scared. Okay, let's go to the next page. In a discussion, truth should be more important than people's sensitivities to screen. Again, my people pleaser, I don't want to make anyone upset. I think because I'm just so empathetic, it's like, it's not worth it, you know? You rarely worry about how your actions affect people. Disagree. That's why I don't like hanging out with people that much, because later on I'll be like, oh no, was that harsh? Oh no, did that sound wrong? Did they get upset? Like, just. I like animals because you can tell. They either purr. Your work style is closer to random energy spikes than to methodical ones. I have like to-do list to the moon, organized with times, and like what I'm gonna do when. I'm just basically very, very organized. I can't live this spontaneous to the wind kind of life. You're often envious of others, yeah, for sure. An interesting book or video game. Game of book. When I was, I'd rather stay home and cuddle with my cat and read than go to a party. Every single time. Like, I'm not saying I don't enjoy social events, because sometimes they can be fun, but if you had to make me choose, I'd probably pick my cat and a good book. Being able to develop a plan and stick to it is the most important part of any project. Okay, slight agree. Like, obviously, definitely the kind of person who makes a plan and tries to stick to it, because then you know it's methodical and you're gonna get it done on time and it'll be good. But things happen and it's important to also be flexible. You really get carried away by fantasies and ideas. Wait, no. Disagree. Yeah, I think so. Like, I'm very optimistic and I'm a dreamer type of thing. You often find yourself lost in thought when you're walking. You do not let other people influence your actions. I disagree, but slightly, because it depends what it is. If it's influence in the sense like, hey, I want to go get sushi, and someone else is like, I'd rather pizza, and I'll be like, okay, whatever, pizza, it's fine. You know, like, if it's not a big deal, I'm happy for the other person to get their way. But there are some things where very, very, just bending over about the step to my ways, like cleaning or, you know, being vegan. Like, I don't care if someone else is like, that's kind of weird, it makes me feel hot about it. You know, you have your things that you're like, no, this is how I'm doing it, type thing. When you sleep, your dreams tend to focus on the real world and its event. Like, slightly, like the last night, and I can really tell you, because are you guys like this too, or am I weird? But my dreams tend to be very kind of inappropriate with the sexual and but also weird, like apocalyptic a lot of time. Like last night I dreamed one of my dreams was the world just kind of ending, and it was like a flood and we were all trapped in our buildings and you'd like fly to them. So sort of real world in the sense that the world is gonna end. It does not take you much time to start getting involved in social activities in your group. Disagree. I'm not a social person, although I like social events, but I'm not a daily, day-to-day group. Like, I have like maybe 3 days out of the week where I can be social, but then I need my other time where I'm just alone. I just only have so much energy for other people because they take a lot of energy out of me, which is why I'm an introvert. School or work, I struggled at because people didn't really understand that. Like, That's why my current roommate is so awesome, because she's the same as me. So she gets that I'm neither of us are gonna talk for a week and then we'll hang out one night. It's not weird. Whereas other people at school or work things, my previous roommates, I think I didn't like them or being rude or snubbing them. It's just that I don't have an inmate to hang out every day. So the answer to that is no, because people think I'm weird. No. You're more of a natural improviser than a careful planner. Your emotions control you more than you control them. Yeah. You enjoy going to social events that involve dress up.
Yes, I love dressing up. I miss high school for the one reason that the parties we would sometimes have were very dressy up. But you know, looking back, you know, my friends are always like, we were wearing lingerie and white. We'd have like Playboy bunny costume parties with morning after like work dressed up parties. Like, I can't think of anything else right now, but we do a lot of dress up parties and I love that. In like the bedroom, I like dressing up and stuff like that too. So I like role playing and getting into character. I think it's fun. You often spend time exploring unrealistic and impractical yet intriguing ideas. I have no idea. I'm not sure. So first though, there's this huge bed and River's sitting right here next to me at the very corner. She wants to be near me. Cats act like they hate every bone, but they love us. You love your mommy, huh? You'd rather improvise than spend you're relatively reserved. So that's why it's slightly disagree, because if I know you well-ish, or it's a small group, even if I don't know you well at all, but like there's like three or four people, what I struggle with when I become kind of shy is when there's a lot of people. And then I feel like people don't want me to talk, they want somebody else. When there's like four of us, it's like you could talk because there's only four of you. Does that make sense? And so in those smaller business, you would find it very difficult to fire a loyal but underperforming employees. Yeah, 100%. You often contemplate the reasons for human existence. No, sometimes, but no, because it freaks me out. Logic is usually more important than heart when it comes to making decisions. Always about the emotions. No, I go with what my heart tells me. Keeping your opinions open is more important than having obstacle. Okay, so I'm agreeing slightly because, like I said, I have a to-do list. I have a very, very organized schedule and plan. But again, like I said, I do also think it's important to be flexible, be able to go with the flow, and kind of use that structure as a base for your plans. You know? If your friend is sad about something, you're more likely to offer emotional support than suggest ways to deal with the problem. I think so. But I am also, that's why I struggle, because I'm very emotional and empathetic, but very practical as well, and would be like, well, there's this and this and this that you could do. I almost want to put middle, because I really do both. Or maybe I don't even offer emotional support. I'm empathetic, but no, but I will be like, oh no, I'm so sorry, and give them love. I really would do both, like I don't know. Okay. You really feel insecure, disagree. Difficulties coming up with a personal timetable and sticking to it. Hmm.
Yeah, agree, but I'm difficult to stick to it because I think I try to pack a lot more into my day work-wise than I'm actually capable. Like, I'll work from the morning when I wake up to when I go to bed with, like, an hour of reading time before bed because I need that for my sanity. But I won't plan for that. I'll plan to finish it at normal time, but it rarely happens. Being right is more important than being clock. Disagree. No. You think that everyone's views should be respected regardless of whether they have supportive effects or not. Yeah. Respected. But if it's something that's harming someone else, then there's only so much you can respect you can have for somebody who's hurting someone else. Do you know what I mean? I'll be too more energetic. I just want to know. I need to sleep for a week. You frequently misplace your things. Disagree, but again, I think because I'm human, I'm an airhead, I'll get lost in thought and do things I don't remember. But everything in my life has a place where it should be, and it's just that sometimes it doesn't work out that way. You see yourself as very emotionally stable. Disagree a little. Your mind is always buzzing with unexpected ideas and plans. Yeah, definitely all. Like, I'm never bored. Never, like, if I didn't have a job, I would have a job. Like, I just always have things on my mind, things to do, ideas. And I'm not just like, I don't just have ideas. I like to think at least that I am able to put a plan together and execute it. You would not call yourself a dreamer. Disagree. A dreamer. But not just a dreamer. You usually find it difficult to relax when talking about it. Generally speaking, you rely more on your experience than your imagination. Yeah, I guess. You worry too much about everything, yes. So from school, you take closer to the walls. Oh, if anyone else like that, I don't like crowds in general. They give me panic. But no tomorrow. But yeah, when you're you have like one wall against you and there's some people here but you still feel safer. Does that make sense? I'd love to know if you guys wrote that too. I mean, clearly if it's on here it must be a common thing. You have a tendency to procrastinate until I don't know. You feel very anxious in such situations. Yeah. You believe that it is more rewarding to be liked by others than be loved. You've always been interested in unconventional ambiguous things. Ambiguous, yeah. I'm not sure what that means. Like, I can't take initiative. But I'm also happy for other people to take initiative. Do it. Oh my god, the results. Okay. Oh yeah, I think I did have. I think this is what I had. INFJ? Okay, let's see. So introverted, but I am still extroverted. I think that's so true right there. Because, like, right here, because I am, like, I'm an introvert, 100%, but I am capable of being extroverted. Oh, yeah, that's another thing that made my boyfriend introvert. So, like I said, we were the same except he was introvert, but then this additional one here, the turbulent, he was like the confident one, whatever the other option for that is. But as turbulent as I am, I think as I get older, I'm becoming more confident. So I almost think I'm a bit surprised right now. I guess I'm depending it all on turbulent, but anyways, energy, we redirect our mental health. So I'm intuitive. It must be nice to see that it's more children, but like, I definitely, because it can be in your head and not stupid, like, I think that is kind of a
connotation of airhead is to be stupid. I don't really know how to describe it. I'm not a stupid person, but in situations, I can be a little unobservant. Like, things can happen. I don't notice. I can be in the middle of a conversation and not notice some creepy guy. Like, I don't let things happen. I'm just gonna be a little silly. Okay, intuitive thinking versus feeling. Yeah. So, like, I can be logical, but I'm gonna always choose emotions, because to me, they're more. It's never worth it to be right or smart. It's just to be kind. That's what life to me is about. This reflects our approach to work, planning, and doing so and judging. So, I guess perspective is to be someone who is spontaneous. They don't make a plan, they go with the flow. So, yeah, 75-25 is what I was saying. I make a plan, but I'm happy to go with the flow. And then, yeah, top one. Okay. Start reading. Oh, okay, so now it's gonna tell me about me. So, I am the advocate. I'm a diplomat whose goal is to serve. Cool. I feel like this is the most interesting thing ever. I really want you guys to take this and tell me the results. Okay, so the advocate personality type is very rare, making up less than 1% of the population. Okay. Like, still, that's a lot of people when you think about it, but okay. But they nonetheless leave their mark on the world. As members of the diplomat role group, advocates have an inborn sense of idealism and morality. Yeah, but sets them apart is that they are not average image people meeting. Oh, that's the only thing I was just saying that I like to think that I am. Like that I dream big, but make it happen. Oh, it's like saying really good about myself. So advocates tend to see helping others as their purpose in life, but while people with this personality type can be found engaging. Yes, you have to do charity work. The real passion is to get to the heart of the issue so that people do not need to be rescued at all. That's really sweet. I always feel like I need to be better to be this, but okay, that's totally nice. I've got a lot to go. I'm only 22, so get too stressed. Okay, so I guess I'll just read through this. I don't want to bore you guys, but this is interesting to me. So advocates indeed share a unique combination of traits. They're soft-spoken. They have very strong opinions and will fight tirelessly for an idea they believe in. They're decisive and strong-willed, but rarely use their energy for personal gain. Advocates will act with creativity, imagination, conviction, and sensitivity, not to create advantage, but to create balance. Egalitarianism and karma are very attractive ideas. Oh, I feel like it's so true. And they tend to believe that nothing would help the world so much as using love and compassion. So I know it's dark. That is me, literally, always. So advocates find it easy to make connections with others and have a powerful, warm, sensitive language speaking in human terms rather than with pure logic. I'm a little not so great with my words because I can talk to them, but in theory. So their friends and colleagues will come to them. Think of them as quiet, extroverted types. That's so true. But they would also do well for their advocates in the town. It would be good for us when we talk to them. This is me to a nutshell. Because I don't really think around people. I come off as extrovert. I have an idea, which is why people, I think, especially a lot of people who are extroverts, don't understand what an introvert really means. They just think we're shy. So they assume that somebody would talk a lot, and it's very like la-di-da, be extroverted. But they also don't understand that introverts do need time to themselves, and it means absolutely nothing about how much they value you or your friendship or your love. It's a rather good thing to recharge, so definitely if any of you are extroverts, remember that. Advocates take great care of other feelings, and they expect the favor to be returned sometimes, giving them the space they need.
Really, though, it's most important for other kids to know to take care of themselves. The passion of their convictions, perfectly capable of carrying them past their breaking point, and if their seal gets out of hand, they can find themselves exhausted, unhealthy, and stressed. Yeah, workaholics, for sure. That's definitely me. This becomes essentially apparent when advocates find themselves up against conflict or criticism. Their sensitivity forces them to do everything they can to evade these seemingly personal attacks. The circumstances are unavoidable. They can fight back in highly irrational and unbelievable ways. To advocate the world is a place full of inequality, it doesn't have to be. No other personality types are better suited to create a movement to fight, to right or wrong. No matter how big or small, advocates just need to remember that while they're busy taking care of the world, they need to take care of themselves too. Okay, so I'll just run through this, because this video is going to be long. So we have a creative, combining a vivid imagination with a strong sense of compassion. We have the creativity to solve non-technical challenges between the limits. People with the average personality type to find the perfect solution for somebody who can. This is so funny. One thing I feel like I'm becoming really like, I'm gonna be like a life coach or career counselor, because I'm just like, I think I'm good, especially about the people around me, of like picking out their strengths and things. It's like, I've been like, you should do this, and here's how you could do it, and I'll write up a methodical plan to become the person you want to be. Like, there's so many insightful, seeing through dishonesty and disingenuous. Yeah, because I can feel like I can be gullible, but I can also, I pick up on people's energy, and I tell people just not good. You know, like, tell me you're put a heart full of when you don't, basically. Inspiring and convincing. I mean, that's nice, but I don't know if I am. That's something to work towards. I need to be better spoken. Okay, I'm gonna have to go because probably for wants to leave. We're also very sensitive. Private, I guess. I don't know who I am. Definitely perfectionist. I always need to have a path and burn out easily. I'm sorry, lover. 1 second. Let me just quickly finish this. Okay, well, I'll link this below as well. My personality type, in case you want to read more. But I'm gonna have to go take care of this naughty kitty now. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. This is a lot of fun to take again. Like I said, take the quiz, or if you've already taken it, let me know in the comments what your personality type is, and tell me a little about it, like especially in terms of how it relates to you, because I have 16 different personalities, so tell me about yourself in relation to your personality type, because I think this is super duper interesting. Reading this. I just love my boyfriend. He's perfect. Okay, I'm gonna go. Thank you for watching. I love you.